So now we look at some very quick facts for today from the prelims perspective. First of all, we will look at a mission of NASA that is called Viper. Okay, this, so Viper mission, remember, is by NASA. So basically, Viper ka full form kya hai? Viper's full form is Volatiles Investigating Polar Exploration Rover. So NASA is basically undertaking this mission to understand ki is it possible for human life to sustain on moon by using the locally available resources. तो यहाँ पर basically इसका main aim है कि ये देखना कि क्या human life वहाँ पे survive कर सकती है on the moon just by using the resources that are available on moon. So basically अगर हम Viper की बात करें तो ये एक mobile robot है, ठीक है, and basically rover as the name suggests है ना. It's basically a rover. So it's basically a mobile robot that will go to the south pole of the moon. ठीक है, it will go to the south pole of the moon and वहां से ये एक close up view लेगा of that location and it will check the concentration of water ice and then it will check eventually how that could be harvested to sustain the human exploration on moon, Mars and beyond. So Viper जो है, it is planned for delivery to the lunar surface in 2023. तो ये जो Viper है, it is the first resource mapping mission on any other celestial body. So resource mapping mission यानी कि क्या? ये एक mission है that is going to identify and analyze the resources that exist on moon. So basically इसका काम होगा कि ये जो concentration of water है and other potential resources that are there on the moon's surface उसको evaluate करेगा. It will evaluate the concentration of water and other potential resources on moon. So what is the significance of this mission? देखिए, आपको पता होगा about the Artemis program. So Artemis, actually इसके three parts हैं, Artemis 1, Artemis 2, Artemis 3, but the major aim of Artemis program, NASA का एक Artemis program है, its main aim is to send the next man and the first woman to the lunar surface by the year 2024. So they want to send, so remember that the first woman to the moon, they want to send the first woman to the moon through this mission. So Viper can be significant because its findings will inform the future landing sites in this Artemis program. It can land, it can help, and it can help in finding the resources because it's going to find the resources on moon. It can say what are the resources that are available to sustain humans agar they have to stay for extended periods. So quickly यहाँ पर एक और चीज देख लेते हैं कि इससे पहले NASA sent humans कब? NASA sent humans to the moon in 1972 during the Apollo mission. Apollo lunar mission के time पर that was the last time NASA sent humans to the moon in 1972. Very quickly at this point also let us try and understand NASA about the moon missions that have been there. See NASA जो है, in the US had tried to put people to the space as early as 1961. It tried to send people to the moon. It was only in 1969 that Neil Armstrong, along with Edwin Aldrin, became the first humans to step on the moon as a part of the Apollo 11 mission. ठीक है, Apollo 11 mission के तहत they went. अब lunar mission की बात अगर हम करें, तो एक्चुअली स्पीकिंग 1959 में सोवियत यूनियन का देर वॉज एन अनक्रूड लूना वन एंड टू एंड दिस बिकेम द फर्स्ट रोवर टू विजिट द मून. उसके बाद ये अपोलो 11 मिशन के पहले NASA had sent three of its robot missions to three classes of its robot missions between the 1960s, during the 1960s, ठीक है. अब फिर 1969 में finally the American astronauts walked on the moon and 1972 में the latest one was in 1972. उसके बाद ऐसा कोई mission NASA के द्वारा नहीं हुआ है. In the sense that there haven't been crewed missions to the moon. फ्रॉम नासा साइड. सो 1990s में यूएस वॉज डूइंग लूनर एक्सप्लोरेशन, बट दे वर नॉट crewed. They were not, people were not sent to the moon. There were missions to the moon. There was lunar exploration happening. Robotic missions were there. There was this lunar prospector. 2009 mein, then there was another series of robotic lunar missions. So as far as humans to the going to the moon is concerned, that hasn't happened in the recent times. Right. Ab dekhi, space moon pe missions to countries have sent, USA has sent its moon missions to the moon. Then there was this European Space Agency's mission, missions to explore the moon have been there. Japan has, China has sent, India has sent, but not humans. Humans have not gone. But so there have been missions to the moon, but so far, after that, after the mission, after the Apollo missions, that was the Apollo 17, which was the last manned lunar landing. After that, humans haven't gone back to the moon. So there have been missions by USA, ESA, Japan, China. So these are the nations or entities that have sent their missions to the moon. So the Soviet Union first, sabse pehle, then the United States, then Japan actually, and then European Space Agency, and then China, then India, then Luxembourg, and sabse latest, Israel. Israel even attempted to send tardigrades, if you remember, and basically that mission crash landed in 2019. Anyhow, so these are the missions to the moon. These are the countries or entities that have sent their missions to the moon. Okay, so we have an idea now. So you have an idea about it now. India has sent Chandrayaan 1, Chandrayaan 2. Baat kare quickly agar, so it began in 2007 and this was actually a result of an agreement between ISRO, that is India's ISRO, and Russia's Roscosmos. Theek hai? But and then this actually yahan par Chandrayaan 1 confirmed the presence of lunar water. So this was a very significant finding of Chandrayaan 1 that detected lunar water. It found evidence of lunar caves, and then it also found that past tectonic activity on the lunar surface. As far as Chandrayaan 2 mission is concerned, it was the second mission to the moon, and it comprised of, so Chandrayaan 2 was basically India's second. So Chandrayaan 2 jo hai, it was India's second mission to the moon, but it actually, as we know, it failed to make a soft landing on the lunar surface. The lander and rover basically malfunctioned and after crash landing and got destroyed. But this mission is still significant because the mission's orbiter and other parts have been functioning normally and they have gathered information. So recently ISRO had actually released the information gathered by the scientific payloads. Basically significant hai kyunki this Chandrayaan 2 has actually talked about, has actually given us information about the presence of water molecules on moon. It has given the most precise information about water molecules on moon till date. It has given us information about minor elements. Bahut sari cheeze aisi hain jo bhi process ho rahi hain. Theek hai? And then it has given us information about solar flares. It has explored the permanently shadowed regions as well as craters and boulders. Another quick fact is that Chandrayaan 1 ke liye, the launch vehicle that was used was PSLV. PSLV was used and that was PSLV C-11. But Chandrayaan 2 ke liye, Chandrayaan 1 ke liye PSLV tha, but Chandrayaan 2 ke liye GSLV Mark 3 was used. Next, very quick fact. So ये जो painted graveware है, basically it was mainly a culture of the Ghagar Hakra Valley and it belonged to the Iron Age. Remember this. This is important. Remember that it belonged to the Iron Age. ठीक है, painted graveware belongs to the Iron Age. That is this later Vedic period. Pottery and its evolution is important. It's an important topic ki kahan par kaun se period mein kaun si tarah ki pottery hoti thi. This is important for us to know. So quickly dekh lete hain about that. सो नियोलिथिक एज की अगर हम बात करें तो इस तरीके की क्रूड पॉटरी जो है हमें देखने के लिए मिलती थी. दैट वॉज द फर्स्ट रेफरेंस ऑफ पॉटरी वॉज मेड इन द नियोलिथिक एज. सो इट इज हैंडमेड पॉटरी बट ड्यूरिंग द लेटर पीरियड फुटव्हील का यूज किया गया था. अब इस टाइम पे नियोलिथिक एज की अगर हम बात करें तो द पॉटरी इज अनग्लेज्ड एंड अनग्लेज्ड यानी कि इसमें कोई शाइन नहीं है. एंड देन इट इज हैंडमेड कोर्स you know like very rough kind of structures and the material is clay that is mixed with mica that was used and us samay pottery pe koi bhi tarike ki painting nahi dekhne ke liye milti thi. Now as far as black and red ware is concerned, this was basically associated with the neolithic phase. Theek hai, neolithic so neolithic phase ke sath this was associated and harappa bronze age in india so they had these एंड आयन एज में भी पाया जाता है. सो बेसिकली वॉट वी कैन डू वी कैन एसोसिएट दिस विथ इट इज राइट टू एसोसिएट दिस विथ द हरप्पन एज ब्लैक एंड रेडवेयर एंड ब्लैक ऑन रेडवेयर ऑल्सो हरप्पन एज. सो इफ यू लुक एट द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ ब्लैक एंड रेडवेयर वी कैन सी दैट इट वॉज सो वाइड स्प्रेड. सो द स्प्रेड ऑफ दिस इन स्पेस आई मीन इन ऑल दीज कल्चर्स and actually it shows there is evidence that this must have been made by several cultures. Agar hum Ganges plain ki baat kare to after this came the painted grey ware culture. Now quickly Harappan civilization may we get to see also the polished ware pottery with rough surface. See हरप्पन सिविलाइजेशन में बोथ पॉलिश टाइप ऑफ पॉटरी एग्जिस्टेड एंड अनपॉलिश बोथ पॉलिश एंड अनपॉलिश एग्जिस्टेड एंड हरप्पन टाइम्स में बेसिकली पॉटरी जो है उसका एक रेड सर्फेस हुआ करता था एंड पॉलिश वेयर्स वेर वेल फायर्ड. सो ज्यादातर पॉटरी जो हरप्पन सिविलाइजेशन में पाई जाती है दैट इज पॉलीक्रोम. उसका मतलब है कि मोर देन टू कलर्स वेर यूज इन द पॉटरी. एंड ज्यादातर पॉटरी जो हरप्पन सिविलाइजेशन में थी दैट वॉज यूटिलिटेरियन इन नेचर एंड दे हैड फ्लैट बेसिस. ऑल्सो ये परफोरेटेड पॉटरी दिस इज समथिंग वेरी स्पेसिफिक. सी परफोरेटेड पॉटरी वॉज ऑल्सो फाउंड एंड दैट माइट हैव बीन यूज फॉर स्ट्रेनिंग लिकर. अब मेच्योर हरप्पन सिविलाइजेशन में द मेच्योर हरप्पन सिविलाइजेशन हैड बर्निश्ड एंड पेंटेड पॉटरी. So there was burial pottery that was found. Burial pottery was specially and distinctly made and it reveals that Harappans had a belief in life after the death. Ab ye jo ochre colored pottery hai, this ochre colored pottery is also known to be existent in the late Harappan cultures. Theek hai, late Harappan cultures mein pai jati hai, that is around 1900 to 1200 BC. I'm not writing the timeline because that I hope something you're aware of. Primarily, ye Chalcolithic age mein tha, theek hai. So, ye jo ochre colored pottery hai, this is identified with a copper hoard culture. And ye jo hai, it is found in the Indo-Gangetic plain. और इट वॉज फाउंड इन द अपर गंगा वैली एंड द गंगा यमुना डोआब एरिया. सो ये जो कलर है ऑकर कलर्ड पॉटरी में कलर जो है इट रेंजेस फ्रॉम ऑरेंज टू रेड एंड बेसिकली माना जाता है कि द टाइमलाइन इज समवेयर 2000 से 1500 बीसी के टाइम पर. सी दीज टाइमलाइंस माइट वेरी अ लिटिल बट द पॉइंट इज जस्ट ट्राई एंड अंडरस्टैंड द एज विद विच इट इज एसोसिएटेड. कीप दैट इन माइंड दैट इज मोर रेलेवेंट फॉर अस फ्रॉम द प्रिलिम्स पर्सपेक्टिव वील बी एबल टू आंसर दैट बिकॉज एज अ डिस्टिंक्ट यू नो दीज एजेस माइट डिफर देर इज नो क्लियर कट डिस्टिंक्शन. सो बेटर रिमेंबर इट एज वाइज. तो ऑल्सो सी देखिए ये जो एलिमेंट्स ऑफ लेट हरप्पन यहाँ पे ऑकर कलर्ड पॉटरी वॉज इन द लेट हरप्पन एंड ऑल्सो द अर्ली वेदिक एज अर्ली वेदिक पीरियड में पाया जाता है. सो ऑकर कलर्ड पॉटरी की अगर बात की जाए तो इट्स आस्क्ड एसोसिएशन तो लेट हरप्पा यू कैन एसोसिएटेड विद लेट हरप्पा एंड ऑल्सो द वेदिक अर्ली वेदिक पीरियड. अब नेक्स्ट वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वन दैट वी जस्ट डिस्कस्ड क्विकली अबाउट वॉज इज द पेंटेड ग्रेवेयर. पेंटेड ग्रेवेयर जो है दिस द वेदिक एरा इट इज एसोसिएटेड विद द वेदिक एरा. रिमेंबर दिस ठीक है. द वेदिक एरा सॉ द इमर्जेंस ऑफ द पेंटेड ग्रेवेयर कल्चर. द ऋग्वेदिक साइट्स हैव पेंटेड ग्रेवेयर. ऋग्वेदिक साइट्स में भी पाए जाते हैं पेंटेड ग्रेवेयर. दैट इज अर्ली वैदिक साइट्स में देर आर पेंटेड ग्रेवेयर स्ट्रक्चर्स, बट ऋग्वेदिक साइट्स में आयर्न ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर एबसेंट. हेंस इट इज कंसिडर्ड अ प्री आयर्न फेज ऑफ द पेंटेड ग्रेवेयर. Rigvedic period is considered as the pre-iron phase of the painted graveware. On the other hand, later Vedic sites, jo hai, the later Vedic sites basically are considered the iron phase of the painted graveware. Later Vedic period ko mana jata hai as the iron phase of the painted graveware culture. This pottery is basically an iron age pottery, we can say, and it is found in the plain of the Ganga. See, it's found in the Gangetic Plain and the Ghagar Hakra Valley. So this is the rough timeline. देखिए आपको timeline जो है कहीं कहीं vary करता हुआ नजर आएगा. So there is no strict. See, कहीं somewhere it might be written 600 BC, somewhere 500 BC. So that is not important. We have to understand the age. It is associated with this Iron Age, or we can say we can basically call it a Vedic era culture. Remember one thing, that Mathura was basically the largest painted graveware site. ठीक है, it was the largest painted graveware site. So if you look at it, it is characterized by a style of grey pottery painted with geometric patterns in black. ठीक है, and they are confined to a few geographical locations like Punjab, Haryana, the Upper Ganga Valley. So this culture is associated with village and town settlements. Also remember this thing specifically, that the later Vedic people were acquainted with four types of pottery. One is black and red ware, the other is black slipped ware, then painted grey ware and red ware. So these are the potteries that are associated with the later Vedic civilization. अब लेटर वेदिक पीरियड के एंड आते आते, दैट इज टुवर्ड्स द वेरी एंड ऑफ द लेटर वेदिक एज, दैट इज अराउंड 6 सेंचुरी बीसीई, वी सी द इमर्जेंस ऑफ अ सेकेंड फेज ऑफ अर्बनाइजेशन. फर्स्ट वाला कौन सा था? इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन. तो यहां पर दिस मार्क्स द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द नदर्न ब्लैक पॉलिश्ड वेयर, NBPW. अब ये जो नदर्न ब्लैक पॉलिश्ड वेयर कल्चर है, दिस बेसिकली हम कह सकते हैं कि दिस पीक्ड with the emergence of the 16 great Mahajanapadas in North India and the subsequent rise of the Mauryan Empire. So this is an association. So what is the takeaway? This is the association that we can remember. ठीक है, हरप्पन एज के साथ वी कैन एसोसिएट ब्लैक एंड रेड वेयर, ब्लैक ऑन रेड वेयर. इसके साथ साथ हमने देखा देर इज दिस पॉलिश्ड वेयर दैट वॉज ऑल्सो देयर, एंड परफोरेटेड पॉटरी ऑल्सो इज एसोसिएटेड विद द हरप्पन एज, राइट. And then polychrome pottery was also associated with the Harappan age. अब ये जो ochre colored pottery है, ochre colored pottery we can associate it with the early Vedic period. We can also associate it towards the later Harappan age, right? And then we have the painted graveware. Painted graveware we mostly associate with the later Vedic period, that is the Iron Age. तो हमने देखा था कि there was a pre-iron phase also, but mostly we will associate painted graveware with the Iron Age or the later Vedic period. ठीक है, so later Vedic period के साथ ज्यादातर associate किया जाता है इसको. remember painted graveware Iron Age वाला association is very very important. And ये कहाँ पे पाया जाता था, that is also important for us to remember. This was found in the Ghagar Hakra Valley and the Gangetic and the Western Gangetic Plain. Okay, and then comes the emergence of the Nadan black polished ware. Actually, though, it originated in the pre-Mauryan age and saw also its peak in the Mauryan age, and also at the time of the rise of the Mahajanapadas, there was this Nadan black polished ware. Remember that association, Mahajanapadas and the Mauryan age associated with this Nadan black polished ware. Post-Mauryan age is associated with red ware. Remember this association. And Gupta age is associated with red ware. So, ye ek association ho gaya. Aur bahut sare facts ho gaye aaj ke liye. So, we will pause this video for now. And baki ka discussion jo hai, next prelims related, baki karenge. Okay, so we actually covered a lot of facts in this. And agar aap dekhenge, so we'll have like a lot of number of facts that we have covered. This association, try and remember.